Since ancient times, people have been wondering where the moon came from. With the development of science and technology, as humans learn more about the moon, it only deepens our doubts about the moon, because more and more scientific exploration data prove that the moon may not be the satellite we previously thought. It's definitely a weird satellite, because there's a weird numerical coincidence between it and the Earth and the Sun. When we understand the secret behind these coincidence numbers, it will feel even more creepy. Here we've summarized some evidence that the moon may be artificial. Evidence 1. Strange lunar surface. We all know that there are many craters on the surface of the moon, formed by meteorites and comet impacts. But the most amazing thing is that no matter how big the crater on the moon is, the deepest depth is 6 kilometers. There are also some craters on the Earth. Scientists have calculated that if a meteorite with a diameter of 16 kilometers hits the Earth at a speed of 50,000 kilometers per second, the depth it penetrates should be 4 to 5 times its diameter. On the moon, however, all the craters are surprisingly shallow. For example, the deepest Gagarin crater on the surface of the moon is only 6.4 kilometers deep, but its impact diameter is 300 kilometers. According to the data of the Earth, its depth should be at least 1,200 kilometers, but in fact the depth of Gagarin crater is only 2% of its diameter. That led to speculation that there was a layer of material 6 to 7 kilometers deep on the moon's surface that was too hard for meteorites to penetrate. So what could that be? Evidence 2, strange astronomical proportions. According to NASA officials, the moon is a very strange so-called celestial body. As a satellite, the moon has an unnatural size ratio, and its size is simply too large for its mother planet. The moon is the fifth largest satellite in the solar system. In the entire solar system, Ganymede, the largest satellite of Jupiter, has a diameter of about 1/27 that of Jupiter, and the largest satellite of Saturn, Titan, has a diameter of 1/24 that of Saturn. The size of the moon is more than 1/4 that of the Earth, which is 27% of the diameter of the Earth. The diameter of the satellites of other planets does not exceed 5% of the parent star. Could it be that the moon is a huge artificial satellite? Evidence 3, always face the Earth with the same side. When the moon revolves around the Earth, it always faces the Earth with the same side. This is very incredible. From an astronomical point of view, geosynchronous satellites have to go through very precise calculations, not to mention the moon that we thought it is unnaturally formed. And no one knows how long the moon has been orbiting the Earth with the same face. If there is a slight difference, it cannot always face the Earth with the same side. Since the moon always faces the Earth on the same side, many people are more curious about what is on the back side of the moon. In the past, astronomers had assumed that the back of the moon should be similar to the front, and there are also many craters and lava seas, but the photos sent back by the spacecraft show that the back of the moon is pitted and rugged, most of which are small craters and mountains, with only a small amount of lava seas. Scientists can't explain the difference between the two sides of the moon. Theoretically, the moon is a natural satellite in space, and for a long time, no matter which side is hit by a meteorite in space, the chances should be the same. How can there be a difference between front and back side? Evidence 4, strange solar eclipse phenomenon. When it comes to solar eclipses, we have to mention the proportional distance between the moon and the Earth. Because the diameter of the sun is about 400 times the diameter of the moon, and the distance from the sun to the Earth is exactly 400 times the distance from the Earth to the moon and the sun are the same size when viewed from the Earth. The moon's orbit is elliptical. When the moon is closer to the Earth, the moon looks equal to or slightly larger than the sun, and if the moon is just between the Earth and the sun at this time, a total solar eclipse will be formed. When the moon is farther away from the Earth, the moon looks slightly smaller than the sun, forming an annular solar eclipse. Is all of the above purely a coincidence? No other planets seem to have this phenomenon. Evidence 5, metals that can't exist on the moon. It is not surprising that the craters on the moon have a lot of lava, but what's strange is that these lavas contain a large amount of extremely rare metal elements on the Earth, such as titanium, chromium, yttrium and so on. These metals are very hard, high temperature resistant, and corrosion resistant, and scientists estimate that melting these metal elements requires at least a high temperature of at least 2000 to 3000 degrees. However, the moon is a dead cold planet in space, and there has been no volcanic activity for at least 3 billion years. So how does the moon produce so many metals that need to be melted at high temperatures? In addition, scientists analyzed 380 kilograms of lunar soil samples brought back by the astronauts and found that they contained pure iron and titanium, which are not found in nature. Evidence 6, hollow moon theory. Some researchers have suggested that the moon is hollow because there is evidence that the moon's tremors travel only over the surface, and no shock waves penetrating the moon can be observed. In addition, when Apollo jettisoned the lunar craft, the moon shook for 15 minutes. It is also reminiscent of whether the moon is a hollow sphere that can continue to vibrate for such a long time. As for the hollow theory of the moon, we will do another episode to explain in detail to you. Please subscribe and follow us. All the signs show that the moon is a very special and coincidental celestial body. Many scientists wonder whether the moon formed naturally or was it built by someone. What do you think? Feel free to leave a comment.